like, yeah, we have 150k, if you need that, just tell us, we put that into the house, you know. They are paying 5k a week, like they're basically
I've got two more boxes coming, which is going to take away 32.
The other half of the group is basically, they don't know this yet though, but Swan, she's involved in their like legal shit, you know, the security.
Do the crates first because they're quicker. 20 and 30.
You know, to bring them in like intern stuff and let them learn everything what's going on, but I just need to make sure that the house we're getting is fully company house, you know what I mean? Did he talk to you guys about the money as well and what I proposed there? So last week we got over 20k, you know, for the company. I need to use some of the money to better product out on the street. That's me saying that I need to buy ventilation, heating, stuff like that. Our own, what? Smalls. And I want to buy them and make it like this is company racks, you know? This is our shit. This is our operation, you know? It shouldn't be owned by private individuals. And I use that money to buy that out, if that makes sense. Yeah. No, I know Smalls is a part of us, but at the same time, I feel like a little bit bad, you know? Like, I remember how hard he worked for that shit, and me kind of like taking it out of the house and putting it in another house. I know. No, I know. Trust me, I told him. No, he hadn't complained to you, but he complained to me, and I tell him to take it up, and I need to do it for him, you know? So, I want him in that house as well. He was so happy yesterday at his company house, and I asked him if he wanted to be a part of it, and he was like, can I? I was like, yeah, fuck you, you're with the company, what the fuck do you mean? So, I think it's all Gucci, but then I... It's good, everything is laid down, I will talk to the boys up north.
Wait, I already made the two crates, I don't need to make any more.
Tell them they need to be interns, they get to know the whole company, and need to listen to every board member and executives, you know?
Okay. So I need to, I've got two crates, I need to make these. So we need 90 plus 16, question mark? Another 8 basic.
No.
8 basic.
We have probably, so basically when we went to 100, we went up from like a percentage from like pushing
to. Just need to put 8 more basic in there. Hello.
Hello, Reggie.
Hello.
How's it going?
You know, just making stuff. Doing my normal shit.
That's cool.
Up with you. Why you being a weird cunt?
It's harder for... What?
Why you being a weird cunt?
What do you mean weird?
Yeah, because
you just sound like you're being a weird cunt. Higher we put the
bar. So I'm feeling a little awkward right now.
Why?
Well, you know, I'm just wondering if you're gonna pay that fine for, you know.
You want me
that
to
trouble
cut you?
I mean, Reggie, come on, man.
You continued that shit, you dumb fuck. Don't even put that on me.
What do you mean I continued that?
You kept yelling that I'm kidnapped, and then you even said Atlas has a fucking weapon. Once did you say you're joking.
Part. No, I did say I was joking. Basically, it stopped after she started chasing us, man.
You didn't at all. You kept saying I was kidnapped as I'm pulling in.
Did I?
Yes. Okay, well, you dickhead. When she said that she was pulling us over. No, you didn't. You didn't until I fucking said, are you kidnapped? You said, no, I'm not. And then that was too late.
Yeah.
Don't fucking put this on me, you dickhead.
Well, I don't remember quite clearly. I just, you know, I don't recall, in all honesty.
You're an idiot. KJ, what do you think about the table upstairs? It looks
good. I need to use the button. What do you mean I'm an idiot?
Ain't no way that you think I was going to fucking pay that fine.
You know what the cop said to me?
What?
I asked him why he was being such a prick. And he said, oh, you know what? It had nothing to do with you.
Yeah, because they got upsetting spaghetti about me.
Yeah, your fucking asshole buddy over there who thought he was a fucking judge or lawyer.
Which I was right.
You were being a
dickhead. Which I was fucking right, but he didn't want to back down. That's their problem, not mine.
I even asked him to read me the charge in the cells, and I said, the key word that I hear there is intentionally. Yep. And I'm not even a fucking lawyer.
Yep, that's what I was trying to say to him, but he says I don't know fucking shit. So if he wants to push the charge to try and prove a point, he was completely fucking wrong. That's on him.
Say, you know, you use me, you know, as a proxy to, you know, have your little fucking pissing contest with that guy.
I mean, I didn't have a pissing contest at all. I told him what it was. He wanted to have the pissing contest. Could have just fucking listened.
Okay. Well, thanks for calling the legal aid for me.
Motherfucker, how dare you ask me if I'm going to fucking pay it? The fuck?
What do you mean?
The fuck is wrong with you?
I don't actually think you're going to pay it. I was just kidding.
You do want to get cut.
No. I have money right now, so I'm okay. I don't need, you know. It was only like $600 or something.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Well, that was interesting day.
Was it?
Yeah. Well, I also ended up in another trunk later on.
Huh?
And, yeah, we got pulled over for that.
For what?
Joyriding, I guess. It was stolen. The car was going like 200 miles per hour. It was actually pretty insane.
It's actually fucking wild.
Yeah, I don't know what kind of car it was. It was blue, kind of looked like a Dominator, but definitely wasn't a Dominator. Anyways, we were looking to, you know, see if anybody wanted to, you know, rent it for the day or anything like that. And one guy that my buddy Irish, you know, went up to and talked to at the hospital seemed chill at first, but then immediately right after went up to a police officer and said, hey, they just tried to rent me that stolen vehicle for the day.
And then
we looked for him after, but didn't find him. His name was like Anvil. We'll find him eventually.
Yeah, that's
fucking piece of shit. Yep. So,
it's good to see you got resisting it. Why?
Yeah, well, I ran.
Why?
Well, we all ran.
But you didn't have to.
I know. But I didn't have anything illegal on me, and you know, I figured if I ran, more chances the driver would get away, and you know, he did get away. So both times I ran, when I didn't need to, the driver got away, and I got resisting, which, I mean, I don't really want to go to jail, but, you know, if it helps a friend not go to jail for a long, much, much longer time, then I guess that's okay.
That's crazy.
What do you mean?
Yeah, you end up putting yourself in a position where you're now catching fines for someone else. Silly.
Yeah, well, I mean, if it was a big deal, like, you know, I'm sure they would cover the fine, I guess, but I don't know. Then I'd have to answer a bunch of questions and shit.
Yeah.
They'd probably search me anyways.
I mean, nothing illegal on you.
Yeah, well, get this. They tried to confiscate my fucking rotten food.
For what? For
investigative purposes.
The fuck?
Yeah, they claimed it was, you know, used in the illegal manufacturing of moonshine. I said, what moonshine?
Yeah, exactly.
You know, I said, if you're going to confiscate my food, then you might as well go to every fucking corner store and send your buns and confiscate their food and say it's used in fucking, you know, moonshine as well.
Actually, yep, incredibly bullshit. Dumb thing.
Yep. Yep. That's what I said. But, yeah, Lenny Hawk was really pushing for it. And, you know, I guess the officer that I had, Maple, was just following orders. And I mean, I talked him out of it.
If they caught you with fucking, like, the moonshine or at a still or something like that, then sure. Yeah. But just because you have the food on you, food's not inherently illegal.
Yeah, same thing as a lockpick. You know, I can have a lockpick, but if I have a lockpick and I stole a car, then, you know, they'll take the lockpick.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
PD doing dumb PD. Dumb PD things, right?
Yeah, I think they're just trying to be assholes. I don't know. I don't know why.
That's really normal PD.
Really? I thought, you know, I mean, they're just doing their job and stuff, but, man, they are stupid and unnecessarily, you know, power abusive.
Yeah.
Like, why?
Like, just cause.
Okay, I guess. Really makes me want to just do terrible things to them.
Yeah, it was kind of the same as joking around with a cop, and next thing they escalated to a point where they want to charge you. Because they decided to escalate it.
We were very clearly joking around.
Oh, it was fucking insanely, like, it was 100% a joke. And the fact that they decide to change it and say it's not, that they want to fucking pin shit on us because of it, it's wild.
Yeah, I that woman, I don't know what her problem was. And then, you know, when they were making those jokes about Abdul and his stomach or whatever, like, you know, like, how is that not an issue? How can they pick and choose what they decide is a joke or not?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Well, it is what it is.
Yep.
So, you have fun hanging out with Atlas?
Oh, we spent some quality time together.
Yeah, I noticed you stayed up real late hanging out with Atlas. Must have had a good time.
Yeah, might hang out with her again today.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll see.
Oh, that's cool. I'm glad, you know. Glad you guys are getting along.
Yeah. Why do you sound jealous, Billy?
Not jealous, you know.
Uh-huh.
All right, maybe a little bit.
What?
Well, you know, I once thought, you know, I would be your protege.
What makes you think that Atlas is a protege of mine?
Seem to have, you know, spent a lot of time with her. And the fact that you didn't kill her to prove a point to me is interesting.
Yeah.
What?
I said yet.
What do you mean yet?
I didn't kill her yet.
Why would you kill her?
And I guess you as well. Oh, no.
Place for you to stash your shit. Me stash my shit. So
sometimes you need to keep people online, Billy.
This isn't about me. I'm not out of line. I've been pretty good lately. I had a great conversation with KJ yesterday. You know, I think we cleared the air about some stuff, so that was good.
I don't know. You did try stepping up to me yesterday.
When?
When I told you to pick up the apple that you threw.
Look, Reggie, I'm just doing what you told me to. You told me I need to, you know, stand up for myself and stop being such a little bitch sometimes. And, you know,
But you should never bite the hand that feeds you, Billy.
Well, yeah, you're not wrong. I wanted to show you, you know, I've been working on it. That's all. I know my place, just like, you know, yours. You're my Benji, right? Benji's your Benji.
What? Not even a close comparison.
Okay. Yeah, well, I guess not, because in that scenario, that makes me you, and then that makes you Benji, and
yeah,
sure, like, yeah. Okay. I can't think of a better example. What? Okay, I'm your Smalls, and you're my KJ.
What?
I don't know. I'm fumbling. Help me.
Who's not helping you? I lost cause, Billy.
Okay. I'm sorry. I've been trying to be, you know, a more strong-minded person.
Mm-hmm.
It's been going okay so far, you know, except for stabbing Manny's best friend. I don't know what's going to happen with that.
Probably nothing.
I told Dahlia yesterday, and I think she was okay with it.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Come from it.
Well, I mean, it's been creating a lot of conversation at the house. And what? That woman started sleeping at the house also. Which is weird, because like she didn't stay at the house before, but suddenly we have an altercation and now she's sleeping there. In Manny's room, and she's married. Like, what the hell's with that? Sleeping in another man's bedroom. Married woman. It's weird.
Mm.
But, you know, who am I to judge?
How many beds are in the room?
I guess she sleeps on a couch in there.
Sure she does.
I don't know. I don't.
Sure.
I don't think Manny is like, you know, I don't think he's like that. I think he's just, you know, deeply emotional, connected to his friends.
Right.
But I mean, I don't really know what goes on.
Surely she sleeps on the couch in his room.
Yeah. Well, I haven't been staying there in case she's, you know, trying to stab me while I sleep. So.
You could just lock your door. What are you gonna do then? Pick the lock and then stab you while you're asleep?
Yeah, but, you know, locks can be picked. Keys can be, like, you know, she can just take the key out of Manny's pocket or whatever while he sleeps. You know, shit like that, or...
I don't know why you're afraid of this person.
Well, it's not that I'm necessarily afraid of them.
You've been around much scarier people than her.
Yeah, but I haven't been in vulnerable situations where I'm just, like, you know, naked in my pile of money sleeping, you know, unconscious. And who knows what can happen, you know? Like,
that's an image I didn't need in my head, Billy.
What do you mean?
That's,
Oh, I didn't show you my new bed. It's just, like, a pallet of money.
That's
where I sleep. Naked.
Yeah, I don't know why you need emphasis at that part.
What, the paper cuts?
Okay.
Yeah, anyways, I'm sure it'll be fine. It'll sort itself out.
Totally.
Once, you know, Dolly and Manny talk about it and stuff like that. And I don't know. I just feel like this keeps happening to Manny. Like, you know, his best friends just become, you know, people the house becomes concerned with, right? Especially since we've been having issues with her group. So...
Why is having issues with her group? What happened with that?
You know, I don't know exactly how it played out. I haven't really followed up on it. But it had to do with McGregor, like, robbing them or something. And then they got mad. And then McGregor had a meeting with their VP. And he had it, like, set up. And then he just showed up, you know, hours after the meeting. But didn't really remember the meeting, so, you know, we can assume, you know, he was, you know, disposed of somewhere and just woke up, you know, local EMS got him or something.
What are you guys doing to answer for that?
Well, it's not like we're a gang, you know, we're
and who's the group?
ADMC.
You guys are just gonna take that. Crazy.
Well, I mean, it's, you know, like I said, I mean, it's not like we're a gang, you know, it's not, we're not going to respond. So essentially the way it seems like it works is, you know, if someone has an issue, it's their issue, unless, you know, the opposing group makes it an issue for the entire group, right?
Yeah. So Sounds like you're a bunch of pussies.
Well, I mean, when I moved in, you know, I talked to them about the Sonya thing, and they basically said, oh, sounds like a you problem. And I said, yeah, I mean, you know, I know it's a me thing. I just wanted to let you all know about my situation in case, you know, it does, you know, ever come to be a thing, you know, that involves you guys. It's only fair to let everybody know, which is essentially the same thing Mac did. And, you know, he basically wanted permission to fuck with them more, and knowing that it could potentially have fallback on the other people in the house. And, you know, everybody said, do what you got to do, or, you know, we stand by you. Well, you know, and some people are like, let's, you know, join. But I mean, I don't really know
how
this shit works.
We stand by you, but we ain't doing shit. Okay.
Well, I don't know how this shit works, man. It's a weird, like, dynamic, you know, because it's just a crew. Like, we're just a crew that lives together. We're not fucking blooded in and ganged, right? But we're still in a way friends who have each other's back.
Yeah, well, that's the thing though, right? Is you're not, but you're crazy if you think that all that smalls get ocean dumped by some dickheads.
No, of course not. You know, I'm down to help out, but I also not in a position where I'm, you know, should be saying, hey, what the fuck are we doing? Like, you know, we need to do something. It's, you know, basically Jenny and Michael calling the shots, I guess. Well, Jenny, I guess, because I think every time, you know, we have a meeting, I don't even think Michael's like, he's there, but he's like not fucking there, you know? I don't know if he cares or if he's just
That's always
distracted.
Michael.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Never pays attention to shit. Goes along with the one person's opinion for it. Michael thing.
Yeah, I mean, I got no problem with it. Like, it's, you know, whatever. I just, I guess I was under the assumption that eventually he's not going to be deputy mayor and, you know, he's going to be some, you know, badass criminal again.
Yeah.
And then when that happens, you know, it's probably going
to
be...
I mean, to be fair, he was never really a badass criminal himself.
Oh, really?
He just had a lot of fucking toys and a lot of money.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah. It was more of like a name that that is made about a person. Their reputation, essentially. But their reputation wasn't anything like, I'm gonna go fucking deal with a whole ass gang kind of deal, you know?
Yeah.
Certain people in the city that you're just like, yeah, look, I just don't want to fuck with them in general, right?
Yeah.
But people still fucked with him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because they wanted his toys?
Various reasons.
Well, I'm curious to see, you know, how the dynamic progresses, I guess. Because, I mean, you're right, like... you know, we shouldn't be letting someone, you know, get treated like that. Even though I'm sure Mac had it coming to him in a way. You know, he's been out there being a menace, robbing people like crazy. So,
oh yeah, I almost slit his throat yesterday.
Oh, why? He didn't try to rob you, did he?
No, he crashed into me and then they told me to bump his car out and I said no, and then he pulls out a wrench and then tells me he's gonna slit my throat. I said, fucking what, cunt?
Oh, he G-checked you?
So then I made him take back what he said.
Is that a G-check or is that just like a, you know,
a slight press?
Okay, press. But
I think it's not ego check. Slight press. Because he thought that I was trying to bitch him out originally, when in reality, he's the one who escalated it first. And then I wasn't taking the shit. Because, I mean, if he still refused, I would have just driven away and then dealt with him later.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's,
I ain't no way you're going to fucking tell me you're going to slit my throat if I don't do what you fucking say. I'm gonna be bitched at by no one for that shit.
Yeah, I'm surprised he said that to you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Interesting.
I ended up taking back what he said. Like, OJ?
It was good.
Oh, did you set up the small appliances yet?
No, not yet. I'm just setting up KJ's room. The desk is done. And the sign.
Nice, hell yeah.
Yeah, I'm doing KJ's room now. Waiting for things to make. Put the couches down as well.
You're doing good work there, man.
I need your fucking praise, you little bitch. What the fuck you doing trying to praise me? I don't need fucking anyone's approval for what I'm doing. Well, fuck you.
Maybe it's not about you, you know? Maybe it's about I feel good complimenting you, huh?
Fuck up, Billy.
All right. Yeah, okay.
I'm going back to what I'm doing.
Yeah, well, I was just about to end this call, so you don't get to end this call because I'm ending this call, okay?
Okay, good end.
Nice talking to you, Reggie.
Hey, can I fix my own car, or do I need to be like...
Have a good one. Bye.
Bye. So you can do it if you're somewhat of a mechanic. However, you need more parts. Master mechanic will use less parts. Did you not get Dre to fix it?
No. Like the parts were not ready for late yesterday. So I need to talk to him. Did you talk to Dre today? Is he around?
Nah, not yet.
Yeah, he said he was gonna be early today to try to get it on.
Have you made all the parts
Imagine,
you need?
Like. It's 98 right now. Imagine like you put it on late last night and it's done now, you know?
Yeah.
12 hours and it's done.
I'm just annoyed that I didn't get to finish my testing today. Fucking annoying, man. Like the
you
Grove.
Want to put up more heating though?
Well, if I put it up now, then I don't know whether or not the fucking humidity does what it does.
Okay.
Because that's the only issue, right? Is I know that ventilation with where we're at the moment doesn't do any more, right?
Okay.
So then I increase the humidity and then I wait to see
so
if
you
it's still...
increased it again.
Yeah, so I increase the humidity and I see if it's still at 44.5 hours. If it's at 44.5 hours, then I increase the heating, then I notice the difference. And if it's within the range that we want, then that's fine. If it's not, then I slightly just increase the heating until it's in that perfect range. Then I divide the amount of racks by the amount of products we have. Boom, there's your number.
There you got the number. Okay, so what you need to do right now is let this be here until tomorrow when it should be done.
Yes.
Because this was put on late. Like when I looked at it before I went to sleep yesterday, it was 100%, you know? Like
he sent me the time. So as long as he does another grow today...
Yeah, he's gonna do another grow. I told him to do like 30 today.
Yeah, because then once these ones pop and they're good, then I can change the heating and then see where they pop at, and then from there it's just either tweaking or you already know exactly what you need, and then that's just gonna go straight into the next
house way. Yeah, because apparently like he was doing it with the guy downstairs and they had like the heating around 300. They pumped up the heating to like 520 or some shit. And then it went from 91 to like 96.
Yeah. See, but then they don't know anything because then you've got to start adding the other stuff. So
And apparently they don't have any humidity. You know what I mean? Like, so they didn't probably need to add that shit now. But the money I'm making for the company with the shit I'm doing, I'm able to use that money for this shit. So we're going to buy new stuff. You know, I have some cash laying around.
You want to preemptively buy, say, another 8 large electrical devices for me? Because I think I bought some the other day. I still have 4?
How many did you buy and how much money did you use for it?
Wait, where did the other ones go? I swear I had more. Oh, 5, yeah. I've been recording it all, give me a sec. So in total, 6860. I've got the receipts for all 3 of them.
Okay, and that is for the humidity.
So that was for humidity vents, and let me just check them all.
Yeah, but then like we need to check because if tomorrow nothing happened and it's still the same, the humidity doesn't add anything extra. then we can use the ones we're using for humidity to, can we use those for
No, so I don't want to. What I want to do, right, is the percentages I've have them at, I want to see if this does any slight tweak for it itself, or if we're at the peak of where it should be, and then we add the heaters, right? Once we've got it to where we need it to be, then I want to start taking away a couple of things and seeing, right, just fine tuning. So yes, it's expensive, but what you've got to think about in your next house, you're going to have more racks, right? Why I see what it is, is it'll be
that
rack
will not
equals
affect anything though, will it?
Well, I think it might. That's the question, right? Is when I look at this,
fine tune it. Yeah, you want to fine tune it this by like 15 racks, basically. So you know, like this is the tweak for 15.
Yeah.
And you put in 30.
And then after that, well, after I've got it at the perfect point, I want to throw another rack in and see if I need to then add more again.
Yeah. But then again, I hope that we can get this house quick so you can test it in that house, you know?
Yeah, because the easiest way to test that, right, is for me to have 10 racks and do what we have, right? And then and then go and put 20 racks in. Exact same setup.
Yeah.
See if it's any different. See if it is per rack. No. But the way I look at it, right, I look at it as rack equals A, right? Heating equals X, humidity equals Y, ventilation equals Z, right? You need X, Y, and Z for A. So that's what I want to try and work out and see if that is that, or if you can literally just go along to any house and set it up to have these exact numbers and you can put 50 fucking racks in, which doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah. No, but it does make sense anyway, though, because you're like... Yeah, well, I'm not going
to... Because then everyone would know exactly what number to put their fucking house at to get it done in fucking a storm.
Yeah, but then again, like, it shouldn't make sense that you have the heating here, but it affects the room next door, you know?
Yeah, no, that doesn't make sense, but,
it is what it is, you know what I mean?
I mean, that's also why you got the ventilation, too.
How many rack.
And move the heat around. But yeah, once we get that.
When I talked to Dre yesterday, it was like, from my understanding, I was like, okay, if they went up 91 to 96 with adding heating, like it's a quick fix to just add heating to 500 and something, and then it will go from ours probably from 94 to 98 99,
yeah,
because we are around 300, you know, so they added like 200 more heating.
I'm just gonna email you the receipts from you too.
Email money and I pay you because I use 6 of my own, so that is like already 12k, you know, off the 20k I already got. That makes sense.
Yeah, so I've still got 5 electrical devices, right, which is going to give me, I wrote it down, give me a sec. It's going to give me an extra 100 of heating. So we're probably going to end up needing a little bit more than that.
Yeah. But like I said, I have the money. I can pay you for this. Send you over if you want to buy whatever you need to buy. I need to send you. Can you give him your state ID as well underneath that?
Yeah.
Do I have it? So I send you that shit. Then I send you the 1,000 for 1,000 for the room, and you said 7k for
the
racks, other racks.
So your room's gonna be done once these three are done. Everything else is in there.
Oh, alright.
So you can start putting things in there now if you want to. It's just the basic sideboards aren't in there yet.
Yeah, baby, yeah.
Just a little storage. Right,
we're Gucci then. Yeah, let me go and send you the money so you get the money. So I'm all paid out with that. All right. Good shit.
Thank you. Right, Lacoop, how you going? All right, once they're done, we put them in, then we need to start working on Dom's one.
Morning, Murray. How you feeling?
I want to do sofas for upstairs later, not now.
Alright, that's good.
Okay.
Like, I could easily just jack up the heating now, right? And boom, shit's done.
To get in contact with me?
I don't want to do it that way. I like being a little bit more meticulous with my stuff. I'm very proud of this room. There's also this I needed to fix.
Yeah, I know that he was heavily into the game back in the days. Alright, I guess he sees, you know, he knows that we are up north, you know, and we're pushing a lot.
We'll just see the line. So much better not having that fucking ugly ass bulkhead there too.
Yeah, we're looking pretty Gucci, I'm not gonna lie. We're looking pretty Gucci.
I don't want to put a light in each of these rooms too. They're not so dark.
Yeah, do that, do that. Alright, bye bye.
I don't have the, there's a fucking item. Did it not make the last fucking box? Fuck this bench. Come on, you cunt. What am I getting stuck on? Do one sec. Alright, back. How much longer is left on this? Come on, give us another high quality sideboard blueprint. Can't wait to fix all of this. Well, it's not just this. Up a little bit of space by moving some things around. What is that thing? It's just a statue. large, like that large fucking vehicle. On Gamba. Break. Went to the wrong place. Avoided. I really like what I did with those tables. Hello. So then we just need to do a lot of these little things, you know, around the place. Oh, fucking tiger in the room. Your name here. I'm doing good. We need to make sure that we've got the chips. Oh my god. I'm missing a chip. That'd be smalls. Alright, how's this going? Another 37 minutes total. That'll get me what I need. Got enough of everything for it. Alright. Got two paint supplies. Wait, which one is this? Good. I'm gonna keep them all together in this one then. All right. So, start setting up Dom's room. We'll just put Dom's room here. Oh, I could just do the name down the wall as well. Might look nicer. Third gap? Fucking is, that's what's throwing me off.